Let there be a thousand blossoms bloom.
Wouldn't believe it. A goddamn bloody adult.
This is it. This is the big one. This is for the girls.
These are just some of Australia's politicians from our minor parties. They're known by many for adding some colour into Australian politics, usually driven by the fact they don't have to toe the major parties' lines. There are more than 30 political parties across Australia, and most of them are minor ones. These include parties like the Animal Justice Party, Centre Alliance, Shooters, Fishers and Farmers Party, and United Australia Party. But where did minor parties come from, and what power will they have in this upcoming election? A minor party is a political party that basically isn't Labor or Liberal. After proportional voting was brought in 1948, it meant a state was more likely to have their Senate seats filled by multiple parties. One of the minor parties drawing a lot of attention this year, due to their multi-million dollar ad campaign, is the United Australia Party. This party was founded in 2013 by mining tycoon Clive Palmer. Clive Palmer's party slogan is "Help us make Australia great." Sound familiar? The UAP is promising to end COVID lockdowns and restrictions on freedom of movement, which at the moment don't seem to be coming back in anyway. It also has a strong stance against censorship. The party says it will end foreign tech giants such as Facebook, YouTube and Twitter from censoring the Australian political debate. Another minor party with a strong reputation is Pauline Hanson's One Nation. Few Australian politicians are as divisive as Pauline Hanson.
Please explain.
Well, in 1996, the then MP came into Parliament rallying against the Asian community, immigration and multicultural policies. Her political bid was short-lived though, losing her seat in the 1998 election.
You're seeing me now, it means I have been murdered.
But Hanson didn't stop there, returning to politics in 2016, this time still rallying against multiculturalism, but focusing on anti-Muslim policies. The controversy didn't stop there. Hanson went on to wear a burqa in Parliament to call for a ban on the garment.
Please explain.
I honestly can't. This election, One Nation is running with policies including closing Australian borders to refugees, withdrawing from the Paris Agreement on climate change, advocating for medical cannabis, and rolling back abortion access. Just a few more minor parties worth a mention. There are the Liberal Democrats, who stand for small L liberalism. The Greens, they also count as a minor party. So how will the minor parties stack up this federal election?
It's not known how much impact the minor parties will have, but I think you can safely say that it will be greater than we're used to. The advent of these, particularly the right-wing minor parties, has been a difficult thing for the coalition, particularly for the Nationals, because these parties tend to be strongest in the regions. They do nibble away at the right flank of the mainstream Conservative parties. Now, the big confuser or the big wild card in all of this is that there are a number of independents running in Liberal seats, in what used to be known as safe Liberal seats, but don't feel particularly safe at the moment. In leafy inner city seats, they're under threat from these so-called teal independents, mostly women, mostly highly credentialed professional women running very well organised campaigns. And these candidates look like they might have some chance of winning.